Hi guys, welcome to the course on power system. In this lecture series, what we'll do is we'll take a look at some of the most common problems that are generally asked in GATE from the subject of power system. This will help you to understand what kind of problems can be asked and how to tackle such kind of problems. Power system actually is a very vast subject. If you go after it all at once, it will seem to be very vast and you might not be able to cover the entire subject. But if you break it down into the number of possible problems that can be asked in GATE, then it is definitely easy to prepare the power system. So in this lecture, what we'll do is we'll first start with power plant. Now in power plant, what you need to understand is first is the concept of base load power plant and peak load power plant. Base load power plants are those which supplies a constant power throughout the year, that is the base portion of the load curve. Which are those? Hydroelectric, then thermal, then nuclear. Whereas peak loads are those which supply power whenever there is a high requirement of power or whenever there is a power surge. So such are wind farm, pumped storage, diesel power plant. Such kind of plants are used for peak load. Other than that, you need to study about economic generation. What is economic generation? In this topic, different factors you need to understand. The first one is load factor. Now, what is this load factor? It is average demand by maximum demand. Other than that, B. Next, you need to know about capacity factor. It is average demand by plant capacity. Then the third one is plant use factor. It is energy generated. How you can find out energy generated? Average demand into 24 hours is the energy generated, divided by capacity into service hours. That is for how much time the plant has been in working. Service hours means out of 24 hours, the duration for which the plant is working. Then is reserve capacity. Reserve capacity is nothing but capacity minus maximum demand. That is, this much power is always reserved with the generating station so that it can supply whenever the load goes beyond the maximum value. So these four factors you need to understand. You need to memorize the formula, because direct one mark question can be asked based on these. So let us start with the problems based on power plant. The first one, the economic prospect of nuclear power generation in India in to a great extent depends on successful development of. The first one is breeder reactor using thorium as blanket and uranium-233 as the fuel. Reactor using plutonium as the fuel, natural uranium as blanket, liquid sodium as coolant, thermal reactor using uranium as fuel, avoiding import of enriched uranium, fast reactor using enriched uranium as fuel, thus avoid import of heavy water. The answer will be A. Because uranium-233 must be used as fuel in order to broaden the economic prospect of nuclear power generation in India. Is it fine? The next one. The operation of nuclear reactor is controlled by controlling the multiplication factor K, defined as. See, in nuclear reactor we have a chain reaction, in which the neutrons are bombarded on the fuel and they will produce energy. Now, if these neutrons are increasing one stage after the other, then these neutrons will go on increasing and it will be an uncontrolled chain reaction. So that is why this k is generally 1, so that number of neutrons are constant and the chain reaction is sustained. Okay. Now it is saying we have to increase the power level. To increase the power level, we have to increase the value of k. But if k is kept at that increased value, the number of neutrons will go on multiplying. In such a case, what happens is, after a certain time, your reaction will be uncontrolled. That is, you can increase the value of k, but you have to bring it down to 1 again. Otherwise, the number of neutrons will go on continuously increasing. So, answer should be D. That is, we have to raise it above k so that neutrons are increased. But then we have to sustain that value, so we have to bring it back to 1. Is it fine? Next, in pumped storage hydropower plant, the electrical machine is made to work alternatively as generator and motor. The efficiency of generator working at the same electrical power as the motor is. So we have to compare the efficiency. And electrical power is same. So what will be the efficiency of generator? Electrical is the output, PE by PE plus P loss. Okay, 1 upon 1 plus P loss by PE. Or 1 plus P loss by PE inverse. What about motor? Electrical is the input. So, output will be input minus loss upon input, because motor electrical terminals are input and mechanical terminals are output. 1 minus P loss by P. In order to compare this, I will expand the efficiency of generator by binomial theorem. So, I can say that efficiency of generator is greater than efficiency of motor. Is it fine? Because as you can see, this value will come out to be higher. Next is, what is approximate efficiency of a thermal power station? It is around 30 to 40%. In case of thermal power station, because in thermal power station efficiency is how much? Eta turbine. Then after turbine, what happens? First of all, before turbine is eta. What we can say is combustion, because first energy will be converted to from let us say calorific value of the fuel, or from the heat energy of the fuel, we have to convert it to steam. Then that steam is used to run the turbine, which runs the alternator. So net efficiency is product of three efficiencies. So what is the entire process? We take a fuel, we combust it. It will produce heat energy. That heat energy is used to heat the water, and that water is converted to steam. That steam will be running the turbine, and that turbine will be driving the shaft of an alternator. So first we'll combust and we'll produce steam, that is eta combustion. Then this steam will be running the turbine, that is eta turbine. And then this turbine will be running the alternator, that is eta alternator. In the next one, it is saying, the load duration curve for a power station is shown in the figure. We have to find the reserve capacity for 70% capacity factor. Okay. Load duration curve. What does this mean? How the load varies with the time. Now from this we can find out different factors like maximum demand. What is maximum demand? 90 megawatt. What about average? Now, average you can find as area upon duration. So, So this is a triangle. So area will be half into 100 into 40 plus area of this rectangle 100 into 50 by total duration, that is 100, that is 70 megawatt. Otherwise, you can also remember, whenever you see a straight line variation, the average is maximum plus minimum by 2, that is 70. But remember, this is only if the curve goes in a straight line, either increasing or decreasing curve, but it must be a straight line, not any other shape. Now, as I told you, capacity factor. What is capacity factor? 0.7. It is average demand by capacity. Now, what is capacity? 70 by 0.7, that is 100 megawatt. Then what about reserve capacity? It will be capacity minus maximum demand, that is 10 megawatt. Okay, that will be the reserve capacity of the plant. That is why I am telling you, you have to memorize these four formulae, as they might be asked in one mark question. In the next one, when a pumped storage power plant is operated in conjunction with a steam power plant, operating cost of steam power plant becomes optimum, load factor of the steam plant is increased, chances of tripping the system decrease, operating in storage plant improves the stability. See, what happens is, the load curve or the load duration curve is varying throughout the day. If the load duration curve is varying throughout the day, the load factor, which is actually average demand by maximum demand, it is less than unity, because maximum is high but average goes low. But what would have been ideal is, if the entire day the curve was equal to average. In this case, average equal to maximum and load factor is unity. So why is such a thing is desirable? Because in that case, the maximum value will be equal to average value. If maximum value is reduced, the reserve capacity is reduced, or we can say the capacity of the power plant required is reduced. Okay? See, if you only have to supply a maximum of 100 megawatt, why would you use a generator of more than 120 megawatt? But if you have to supply a maximum load of 150 megawatt, generator capacity must certainly be higher than that power. Okay? So that is what we need to take care. If maximum demand is brought down to the average level, the cost will be reduced. Now what happens is, in this load curve, if our steam power plant supplies this base load or the constant power, and this peak or the variation is taken care by pumped storage, then the curve of steam power plant will become more uniform and its load factor will improve. Okay, that is why we want to obtain a constant characteristic for base load plant, and we want that the variation should be taken care by the peak load power plants. Is it fine? But in this topic, you do not need to study about different power plants such as nuclear, thermal. Such kind of questions are very rare in GATE, and it is not worthwhile spending your time in this. Okay, just remember the economic power generation and the concept of base and the peak load power plant. Don't go into much details like how nuclear power plant works, how hydroelectric works. Those details are not necessary here. Moving on to next topic, that is parameters of the transmission line. In this topic, actually, two parameters are important. First one is inductance. Now, in inductance, there are several cases, like first one, single phase two wire. In single phase two wire, the inductance is mu naught by pi ln d by r. then three phase here, inductance per phase is mu naught by 2 pi ln GMD, sorry, D by R dash, GMD by R dash. What is R dash? In both the cases, 0.7788 R. But this concept does not end here. Then we move on to the case of self and mutual GMD. Okay. This concept is used in case of bundled and stranded conductors. So, first of all, let us talk about self GMD. If basically you have more than one conductor per phase, let me call it as A1 and A2, and they are placed at certain distance S, then what happens? DSA is D A1 A1, A1 A2, A2 A1, A2 A2. So, we have kept 4 distances, so power 1 by 4. So, remember we have to take all combinations of distances within a single phase. DA1 A1 is nothing but R dash, A1 A2 is S, A2 A1 is also S, A2 A2 is again R dash. So that is R dash S under root. Okay. So, remember whenever two conductors are kept in a straight line, you can evaluate using one conductor and that will be equal for both the conductors. And let me generalize this. If there were three conductors placed at the corners of an equilateral triangle, then evaluating for one conductor will give you the expression for the entire bundled conductor. Like DSA in this case will be R dash. Suppose I am calculating for this one. R dash into D into D. And remember, the number of distances inside this is reciprocal of that is power, because we are taking geometric mean. Is it fine? So whenever multiple conductors are placed at the corners of a regular polygon, evaluating the self GMD for one conductor is equal to the self GMD of the entire combination. Then what about mutual GMD? In mutual GMD, we have to consider two different phases like A1, A2, and at some distance we have B1, B2. So mutual GMD will be D A1, B1, A1, B2, A2, B1, A2, B2 raised to the power 1 by 4. Okay, that is, you have to take all possible combination between one phase and the other phase. For self GMD, you have to take all the possible combination within a single phase. Okay, so that is what you need to understand for deriving the self and mutual GMD. Now the other parameter is capacitance. In single phase 2 wire, it is pi epsilon naught epsilon r ln d by r. Sorry, c. For 3 phase, it is 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r ln gmd by r. So, capacitance formula, if you understand, there is only one difference. First of all, the log term is in the denominator instead of numerator, and the other thing is that R dash is replaced by R. It is because there is no internal electric field in a conductor, but we consider internal magnetic field in a conductor. So remember, all the calculation like self and mutual GMD will remain same, but at every place you have to replace R prime by R. That you have to do in every place, then you can evaluate the capacitance. And this factor of R prime comes due to internal inductance, which is 0.05 millihenry per kilometer. That is why this factor of R prime comes. Also remember, the unit of inductance will be millihenry per kilometer, whereas capacitance will be microfarad per kilometer. These parameters are distributed in nature. So let us see few problems. The first one, calculate GMR of each of the unconventional conductors shown in the figure in terms of radius R of individual strand. That is, it is saying it has a radius R. So if you join the centers of these strands, you can easily see they are forming a square of side 2R. Now for four conductor, a regular polygon means a square. For three conductor, it is equilateral triangle. So as I told you, for regular polygon, evaluating only for one conductor will give you the result for the entire set. So let me evaluate for one only. Okay. So it will be 1 1 1 2 1 3 1 4. What is 1 1? R dash. What is 1 2? 2 R. What is 1 3? 2 root 2 R. 1 4 is 2 R. Okay, because 1 3 is nothing but the diagonal of a square, that is side length multiplied by root 2. Now substitute R dash, 0.7788 R into 8 root 2 R cube. So how much will this come out to be? This will come out to be 1.72 R. Answer will be C. Okay, if you remember this point, that whenever conductors are arranged at the corners of regular polygon, you can evaluate for one conductor and that will be applicable for the entire set, then what this means is your effort will be saved, because you will not have to calculate 16 combination, because 4 conductors means 16 combination, but I can directly do it in terms of 4 combinations. The next one, calculate the inductance per kilometer per phase of single circuit using two bundled conductor per phase as shown. Now there are two things. One is called as bundled conductor, other is called as double circuit line. In bundled conductor, actually the distance between two conductors of same phase, that is 40 cm, and between different phases 6.5 cm. Let me call it as S, this is D. So S is much less than D, but here S and D are comparable. Now we'll make use of this fact that S is much less than D. If you see, you can call it as bundled conductor if S is less than or equal to D by 10. If it is less than 10 times, sorry, 1/10 of the distance, then you can call it as bundled conductor. Now, what happens? First of all, we have to evaluate self GMD. Now, between each of the three phase conductors, the distance will be same. Actually, this should be C. Based on that, we can evaluate self GMD of one. It will be equal to the others. Now, what is the thing that I told you about regular polygon? Evaluate for one conductor, it is applicable for all the others. For two conductors, a regular polygon is a straight line. So, what will be there? I'll write DAA. DAA dash. That is, DAA is R dash into 40 centimeter or 0.4 meter. Now what is the radius? Diameter is given to me as 5 centimeter. So radius will be 2.5. So what will this come out to be DSA? Self GMD will come out to be 0.0882 meter. That is the self GMD of one phase. Now what about mutual GMD? If you had to calculate, let us say, mutual GMD between AB, it will be D AB AB dash a dash b, a dash b dash. But if this distance s is much smaller than d, then you can approximate it to be d. Okay, that is the beauty of bundled conductor. If you see a bundled conductor system, you can make this approximation provided s is much less than d by 10 or s is less than equal to d by 10. But remember, you cannot ignore this distance in self GMD. You can only ignore it in mutual GMD. So DAB is 6.5. DBC by similar logic is 6.5. But DAC is 13. Okay. Now mutual GMD in three phase is DAB, BC, CA, cube root. That is 6.5 into 6.5 into 13 cube root. So this will come out to be how much? 8.1894. Now once I have the knowledge of self and mutual GMD, what we can do is we can evaluate the inductance. And remember, in three phase we only evaluate inductance per phase, because three phase system has three conductors, and if it is balanced system, we'll analyze it on the per phase basis. So what it will be? Mu naught by 2 pi ln dm by ds. Mu naught by 2 pi is directly 0.2 millihenry per kilometer. Actually 8.1894 by 0.0882. so how much will this come out to be? 0.906 millihenry per kilometer. Okay, so directly you can remember that mu naught by 2 pi is 0.2 millihenry per kilometer. In the next one, see, next one is based on three phase double circuit line. As I told you, double circuit line is when the distance between two conductors of the same phase is comparable to the distance between conductors of different phase. Here diameter of each conductor is 2 cm. The line is transposed. We have to find the capacitance. So when you see this word capacitance, you have to remember we will not use R dash here. We will only use R. Is it fine? So let us start it. First, let us evaluate the mutual GMD of A, B. See, the how much above A is above B, how much distance it is lying above B, 2 meter, and C is lying the same distance below B. Is it fine? That is, the height of A from B is exactly equal to the depth of C from B. If A and C are symmetrically placed above and below B, I can say DAB equal to DBC. Okay, that will save the effort of evaluating two distances separately. Now there are two conductors in A phase, A and A dash, two in B phase, B and B dash. So what is their mutual GMD? AB, AB dash, A dash B, A dash B dash. Is it fine? Now, distance between AB is 2 meter. What about AB dash? You can apply Pythagoras theorem. This is 6, this is 2. It will come out to be under root 40. What about A dash B? A dash B will again be under root 40. What about A dash B dash? It is 2. So how much will this come out to be? 3.556 meter. But DAC will be different. How much will it be? DAC, DAC dash, A dash C, A dash C dash. What is DAC? 4 meter. AC dash, it is 6 meter. A dash C is 6, A dash C dash is 4. So how much does this come out to be? 4.8989. Now what about mutual GMD? It will be geometric mean of AB, BC and AC. If you take geometric mean of these three distances, you will get 3.9567 meter. Okay, that is mutual GMD. Now let us talk about self GMD. For self GMD, if you see, distance between A and A dash is same as distance between C and C dash. So what I'll say, DSA will be equal to DSC. Now when two conductors are in straight line, you can directly evaluate like this. Remember, we will not use R prime because it is capacitance. So radius is 1 centimeter, that is 0.01, and S, that is the distance between two conductors belonging to same phase, can be evaluated by Pythagoras theorem. This is 6, this is 4. So how much will this come out to be? Under root 52. So this distance comes out to be 0.2685. What about DSB? Again, R into S, 0.01. What is the distance between two conductors of B phase? It is 6 meter. So this will be 0.2449. Now we have three self GMD, and as the name suggests, geometric mean. We have to take geometric mean of these three distances. So DS will be 0.2685 into 0.2685, because two distances are equal, 0.2449. So how much will this come out to be? 0.2604. What about inductance now? Per phase inductance will be 0.2 ln mutual GMD. How much? 4.8989 by 0.2604. Okay, so how much will this come out to be? This will be actually, sorry, I committed one mistake. We have to evaluate the capacitance. Okay, it was actually 0.2604. So if you evaluate capacitance, it will be 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln mutual by self. That is 2 pi into 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 divided by log of d is 4.8989 by 0.2604. If you substitute this value in calculator, what you will get is, you will get the capacitance 0.0204 microfarad per kilometer. So answer will be B. Okay, so do remember which parameter is being asked. If it is inductance, you will use R dash. If it is capacitance, you will use R. In the next one, it is saying we have a single phase two wire system, that is one forward conductor and one is the return conductor. Okay, this must be actually R1. Now it is saying conductor A forms a forward path, B1, B2, B3 forms the return path. We only have to find inductance of forward path. Is it fine? Only forward path. So first evaluate mutual GMD. It will be D, AB1, AB2, AB3. That is combination of A with all the three conductors. AB1 will be how much? Under root 5. AB2 will be 2, AB3 will be root 5. So this mutual GMD will be 2.1544 meter. Okay, now what about the self? In case of single conductor, we, instead of self GMD, we take GMR, which is equal to R dash. In R dash, we'll use R1 only, 0.7788 into 2 centimeter, that is 0.02 meter. So what about inductance of forward path? 0.2 ln mutual GMD by self GMD, or we can say GMR. For single conductor use GMR, for bundled conductor it is self GMD. 0.986 millihenry per kilometer. Okay, answer will be B. Is it fine? So that is how you evaluate the transmission line parameters such as inductance and capacitance. So this will be all from this lecture. In the next lecture, we will see about performance of transmission lines such as short, medium and the long line. Thank you.